Canada is facing a critical shortage of healthcare workers that everyone acknowledges but seems unable to solve. The reality is that our population overall is getting older. Recently, the number of Canadians over age 65 surpassed our youth age 15 and under for the first time. That's why some are calling that aging demographic an existential threat, on par with climate change. Older populations demand significantly more healthcare services. But if we lack enough workers to provide those services, where do we turn? There are thousands of internationally trained workers residing in Canada today who could have fulfilling careers in healthcare. So why don't they? For foreign-trained healthcare workers, the pathway in Canada is confusing and difficult to navigate, with so many paths and none of them with a clear end in sight. They're a lot like roadblocks. For example, if someone wants to work as a nurse in Canada, let's call our nurse Daisy. They are met by dozens of nursing regulators across the country, each with its own system for applications and a range of fees to apply. Undaunted, Daisy keeps going. But she discovers that the records of her education and employment history are held up by issuing bodies that have since folded or have lost them. Yet another situation out of her control to slow Daisy down. Next comes a test for language proficiency in English or French. For a surprising amount of workers like Daisy, not passing the test could put the brakes on a career move or discourage them from continuing despite being functionally literate in either language. Then there's the skills assessment testing requirements, a three-part exam with an oral, written, and practical component. It has a $2,000 price tag to conduct the test. If Daisy has too many undemonstrated competencies, she could be on the hook financially to repeat some or all of that nursing education. Many of these education programs have waiting lists or promised results they cannot deliver, delaying Daisy's goal of working as a nurse in Canada for months and sometimes years. If, however, Daisy is able to move forward, she'll then have to write a nursing exam. Great news! Daisy has passed the exam, but the process so far has taken years, leaving Daisy paying thousands of dollars for training, travel, exams, and accommodation. At this stage, for Daisy to put down roots in Canada as a nurse, she'll have to navigate a complicated immigration pathway that does not prioritize internationally trained healthcare professionals. This process could take as much as 5 years or longer. For far too many internationally trained nurses and health professionals, the path becomes too complicated and leads to a dead end. There is a better way. At BC Care Providers, we're working with organizations nationwide to advocate for a simple and clear pathway for internationally trained nurses like Daisy. We're calling upon the federal, provincial, and territorial governments, as well as nursing regulators, to work with us to create a new streamlined approach. By expediting the ability of healthcare professionals to work in the field for which they're qualified, the sooner we can help solve Canada's health human resources crisis in seniors care.